One of the most difficult things about being in tech or breaking into tech is trying to keep up with all the tech trends. There is so much to learn. It seems like every day something new is coming out, something new to learn. And it brings you to the question, how am I ever going to keep up with all this? Today, we are going to be talking about some ways that I keep up with the latest tech trends. Before I get started though, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech and coding related videos. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up and also leave in the comments other videos you want to see. As you know, that's really how I make these videos, is based on what questions you have and what topics you want me to cover. Speaking of tech trends, you know I have been putting a lot of my time and energy into learning blockchain development. It is something I have a huge passion for and am very interested in. Alongside that, I always try and share with you different resources and tools that I find along the way so that you too can check them out and continue learning with me. Speaking of, I really wanted to share with you about Cudos, which is a blockchain-based distributed computing network that allows users to rent different computing power to and from the network in exchange for cryptocurrency or fiat currency. Cudos empowers users who have access to excess computing power and creates an economically superior green alternative to AWS and other cloud computer providers. Think of it like the Airbnb or Uber of computing. I also thought it was really cool how they are a huge green alternative to AWS and other cloud computer providers. Not to mention they have a huge community online, which I think is really amazing to continue to learn from and engage with others in that community. So I've linked down below both their Telegram and Discord channels, so make sure to click on them and go check them out. Keeping up with technology can feel like a job in itself. You're working full-time in the tech industry, whether you are a designer, QA, software engineer, or any role really. And you're trying to balance both your day job, probably have a side hustle of some sorts if you work in tech, and personal life. It's just so much. How are you expected to keep up with the latest tech trends? You can hardly keep up with work itself. Or maybe that's just me anyways. I have found there are a few ways that really help me stay connected with tech trends and different things coming down the pipeline without having to feel super overwhelmed. The first one being joining some newsletters. I find having some tech newsletters that come into my inbox, whether it be weekly or monthly, a really great way to easily keep on top of tech trends coming down. I'm a part of a few newsletters, and one thing I notice is as there are hot tech topics coming down the pipeline, you really see a trend where it be different newsletter headings or titles in it or topics in it, and they'll kind of all be to some degree the same topics because it's what's trending. From there, if a topic really interests me that's trending, I will start doing my own research. But if it's a topic that's trending and I don't really have any interest in it, just being aware that it's trending and what it's all about by reading, you know, a paragraph on it in the newsletter is enough for me. Okay, one of my favorite newsletters that I really like is TLDR, which stands for Too Long, Didn't Read. And I really like this pretty much, as you can guess, based on the title. It's short snippets of interesting tech that's coming up and keeps me informed. Another newsletter that I really like is called The Hustle. It gets delivered to me and it's a really short newsletter that covers a lot of different business and tech trending topics in under 5 minutes. So it's a quick read. And once again, if there are headlines in that newsletter that really entice me, I'll go and do my own research. Okay, next thing I do is I am a part of a few online groups. So some Slack groups or some Discord groups. I'm definitely not active in them, meaning I'm not participating in the discussions or even sharing different resources I find just because of lack of time. But I'm very thankful for the people who are active in them and share different resources. I'll link some Slack and Discord channels down below. And it's a great way if you are interested in engaging with the tech community a little bit further and seeing what other people are working on or maybe reading about, to stay connected in the tech community, even if you are, like myself, working remote, which can feel kind of isolating at times. Having these different groups to be a part of is a great way to feel connected to the greater picture, the bigger picture. Okay, another way I always stay up to date with tech trends is social media. And some of you I know either love social media or don't love it, and that's totally fine. I am someone that I think I'm a huge believer of, if you are following the right accounts, quality accounts that are providing what you are looking to hope to get out of social media, it can be a really positive place to be. For me, I use social media, obviously, for Tiff and Tech to share different tech and inspire others to break into tech. But I also use it to see what other people are working on, what's trending. And how I do that is ensure I'm following different tech accounts that I really love. I'm going to link down below some different tech Instagrams that I'm a huge fan of. One of the more recent ones, as you know, I've really dove into, as I said multiple times in this video, blockchain and cryptocurrency and really Web3 as a whole. And with that comes the metaverse. And one of the Instagram accounts that I'm obsessed with currently is called The Metaverse. And I think they're almost at 1 million followers, and they post 2 to 3 times a day different news about blockchain, cryptocurrency, virtual reality. And they do it in really nice snippets. So you just get like the, I don't know, under 30 seconds of what's going on. And it's a great way to stay informed. And I find also too inspired to see what other people are doing. Another way I stay up to date with tech trends is to learn, to dedicate X amount of time in my week, even if it's 30 minutes to an hour a week, to learn about the new technologies. As a software developer, it's my job to ensure I'm up to date with best practices and standards, and that requires taking time to learn. You really need to prioritize learning and carve out time, because I know we all are so busy and there isn't enough time in a day to do everything. So you need to make it a priority and understand just how important it is. When I learn new things, I find that it's a great way to A, learn about a new technology, but also two, it shows me what is trending out there. Even if you spend a week learning different, very high levels, different parts of the technologies, whether it be cloud or whether it be, as I mentioned, blockchain, or a little bit more about a specific, you know, programming language. You don't need to dive into it to become a professional, but just spend a few, maybe an hour a week on a different technology and see which one kind of sticks and which one you really enjoy, because then maybe you'll end up being really engulfed in that. Engulfed? Is that a word? Engulfed? Taken. Let's say taken by that topic and want to kind of further your knowledge with that. Okay, the last way I stay up to date with tech trends is talking to my friends. Even if they aren't in tech, I feel like a lot of the tech trends recently have touched everyone's so fascinated by technology and reading about it online, and maybe it's just my friends, but I think it's pretty much everyone nowadays, and being able to talk about what's coming up and what technology companies were in the news or trending on social media, and just having conversations with people that are in tech, and also equally, if not more important, conversations with people that are not in tech to get their perspectives on it as well, because I find it can be so different from one person to the next that it's just really important to get a lot of perspective on it by speaking to different people. I really hope this video will help you keep up on tech trends. Just remember, the most important thing is you cannot keep up with all tech trends. Once you realize that and accept that, I think it makes being in tech a lot more fun and a lot less pressure. We put a lot of pressure on ourselves to know it all, especially as technologists, and have it all figured out. But at the end of the day, that's absolutely impossible. So find ways to just get these snippets of information at a very high level. And when something interests you, then dive into it further. Thank you all for watching this video. I hope you found it very valuable and helpful in your tech journey. Make sure, if you haven't already, to hit that subscribe button for more tech and coding related content. Shout out to some of these subscribers here. As always, I love you. I see you. You all are just, you make every day the best day, reading your comments and questions. And so many of you take so much time to write really thought-provoking comments, and I just love reading through them all, so thank you for that. Also, make sure to click the links down below to check out Cudos and learn more about them and check out their communities. Okay, I'll see you all soon. Thanks, everyone. Ice in my veins.